recognized symbol of the Galapagos Islands, but sadly their numbers are dwindling. NBC's George Lewis has an exclusive look at what scientists are trying to do to change that.
He's the world's most famous tortoise, seen by hundreds of thousands of Galapagos visitors.
All our friends.
Lonesome George, so named because when he was rescued from this island, Pinta, in 1972, there were no more tortoises here. None. Blame man for the extinction. Over centuries, sailors and pirates hauled tortoises away to eat them. More recently, humans introduced goats to the Galapagos as another source of food. On some of the islands, the goats multiplied like crazy and devoured the same plants the tortoises eat, denuding the hillsides. Jack Nelson, a longtime Galapagos resident, remembers what it was like on Pinta.
There must have been at least 100,000, 200,000 goats on the island.
Until the Galapagos National Park eradicated the goats, slaughtering them. Which paved the way for this, what a team of Galapagos Park officials and American scientists call the re-tortoising of Pinta.
Yeah, baja.
39 of the creatures fitted with radio tracking devices brought here by boat from the Tortoise Breeding Center on Santa Cruz Island. Two dozen park rangers carried the tortoises, weighing as much as 200 pounds apiece, up a steep rock-strewn hillside to their new home.
By returning tortoises to Pinta, we re-establish a population of habitat engineers, the natural habitat engineers of Galapagos.
The idea is the tortoises will restore the balance of nature by controlling the vegetation without destroying it. A team of students from the State University of New York College of Environment, Science, and Forestry in Syracuse will camp out with the tortoises for 10 weeks, monitoring their movements.
It's a very special experience. We all feel very lucky to be here at all and to spend so much time here. It's a real gift.
Back at the breeding center, efforts to get George to father more Pinta tortoises have not worked, as he's turned out to be more of a dud than a stud. Plan B is to create a colony on Pinta with tortoises genetically similar to George. So the 39 non-native tortoises transplanted there so far have been sterilized to prevent crossbreeding.
The scientific team hopes these tortoises will have a long-term impact here because they live to an age of 150 or 200. Just think, in tortoise years, I'm still a teenager.
Their work of restoring the island will take centuries. But, as we all learned from the fable of the tortoise and the hare, slow and steady wins the race. For today, George Lewis, NBC News, Pinta Island, the Galapagos.
Was that the dawn or dawn in the morning?
Are you talking about because the hare? They're impressive.
Yeah, they're big.
You've seen them in the wild.
In the Galapagos, and they are so enormous that you're stunned by them. But thank goodness they're slow moving. Yeah. You know,
what's the difference between the tortoise and the turtle? Is one goes in,
one's one, one,